little pond. I like to fish a lot. Not many people know it's here. Not many people know the size of the fish that are in this. But obviously you can see there's not really a trail into it either. So limits the number of people that come into it. Means better fishing for me.
My name is Kevin Burrall, 25 years old. I'm from Queensbury, New York, in the foothills of the Adirondacks. You can see some of the Adirondacks here behind me. This is a pond in the mountains not far from my house. I like to fish at a lot. There's a lot of good fish in here. Not many people know about it. My fishing experience, you know, I've been fishing my whole life. I started as a young kid with my grandfather. I can remember him taking me into the woods to fish for trout, which was a lot of fun. And as I grew older, my love of fishing grew. And I can remember being a kid balancing my tackle box and my fishing pole on my handlebars and my bike and trying to ride my bike down the street to go to a local pond to fish pretty much every day. I mean, I'd go to school, I'd get off the bus, I'd run home, grab my tackle box, ride my bike down to the pond and fish. Every day in the summer I was fishing too as a kid. There was a time actually I remember when I was about 12, I rode my bike, tackle box in hand, about 30 miles over the mountain here down to the Hudson River to fish, and my parents didn't know where I was. They called the police. They thought maybe I went missing. Got home, was in a little bit of trouble, but you know, it was a good story, a good time, caught a few fish, and that's all I cared about at the time. I'm most experienced with Adirondack ponds and lakes and streams. I do a lot of backwoods. I like to hike into these ponds and troll for trout or fly fish these rivers. I do a lot of fly fishing, trout, salmon, anything like that. I love fishing for them in the summer when it's real hot, like it is right now. We've had quite the drought, so the trout fishing hasn't been all that great. So I've been fishing for a lot of smallmouth in the river, largemouth in ponds like this. I do both fly and spin fishing. Fly fishing is just more of a challenge for me, more exciting. Catch a little guy on a fly rod, it feels like it weighs about 15 pounds. But, you know, if the situation presents itself where spin casting is the best or bait casting, that's the way I go. You know, I'm pretty experienced ice fishing, jigging, trolling, things like that. Not much experience in deep sea fishing, but, you know, he put me on a boat, give me a rod and reel, and I'll do my best. You know, I adapt well. I can do anything you ask. You ask me a spearfish, I'll be able to do it. I love the water, love fishing. In any situation, I can adapt well, and I guarantee you I'll go out there, and I'll do my best, and I'll do well.
You know, being only 25, I feel like, you know, I might not have as much experience as a lot of guys out there, but, in this area, in the Adirondacks, you know, I'm really, really experienced. You know, I do, like I said, I do a lot of fishing every chance I can. But, you know, I'm young, I'm energetic, I'm fun, I like to have a good time. I got a lot to learn from a lot of other people, I know that. So, you know, I'm not a professional, I'm not a guy, but I might be an underdog going into the competition. But I have the energy, I have the intelligence, I'm smart, I'm quick, capable, I'm quick, you know. I know I can adapt to any situation you come up with and really put forth everything. You know, I'm not afraid to do what I have to do.
I'm not a professional.
professional fisherman. I don't get paid. I'm not a guide. I don't own a charter business. I don't bring people out and you know, do it for money. But I do take out friends all the time. You know, I'm just an amateur and I'd love to do it. You know, I fish every day that I can. Fish days off. Even if I have to work, I'll fish in the morning before work. I'll fish after work. Sometimes I even fish during work, which hasn't gone over too well sometimes with my boss, but that's another story. And luckily I worked on Lake George in the Adirondack Mountains, which is fantastic fishing, beautiful water, beautiful lake. You know, I can't complain about it at all. I think I'll do best at any challenges you can come up with that are physically demanding. I'm in great shape. I was a track and field athlete in high school and in college. And also I'm currently a track and field coach at the high school level, which I did coach at the college level too. But you know, I'm just really competitive, in great shape. I'm stay active. You know, I work out 5-6 days a week. I do what I can. And if you come up with some kind of a physically challenging activity, I tell you right now, I'm probably going to win it. And if I don't win it, I'm going to be right at the top because I don't like to quit. I don't like to lose. I don't like to get beat. So I'll put my body through whatever it takes to get to the finish and to win. I consider myself a thrill seeker? Definitely. I mean, I'll do anything you ask. I enjoy hiking and camping in the Adirondacks, and you know, it wasn't hard enough for me or thrilling enough for me to do it in the summer when the weather's beautiful like it is today. So I decided I'd do some overnight winter expeditions in the High Peaks area, where it regularly gets down to, you know, negative 15, negative 20 degrees. So I'm out there camping in that weather and just for the fun of it, trying not to die. Other things I do thrill seeking, I mean, I was always that kid, you know, hop on the bike, go off the biggest jump you could find, try not to break a bone, you know, that was me. You name it, I'll do it. I spent some time in the Bahamas when I was in college with a couple friends doing research, and while we were down there, we're snorkeling around the reefs, you know, if I saw a shark, I was the first person to go right up and try to get as close as I could to this thing. You know, I can remember seeing a couple of the nurse sharks, which are a little less harmless, or a little less harmful. On the bottom, and you know, I was the guy that'd go down and grab onto their tail and see how far I could ride them. Who doesn't? I mean, I love being out in nature, being out in the woods, doing it alone with buddies. You know, it's great to have friends around to fish with, and you know, just, it's awesome. I mean, I can't complain. I just love to go out there and catch as many as I can, compete with friends, you know, who can catch the most, who can catch the biggest, who can catch them the fastest. And just being out there, you know, that's all that matters to me. It's great to be out away from the, you know, everyday life and, you know, worries, and it's just a great escape to get out and just not worry about anything but what you're doing at this moment, fishing, and enjoy it, you know? And, you know, it's great to be out in nature and enjoy that, but I'm going to be honest with you, it's not too bad to catch a few big fish either. If I had to describe myself, I'd say I'm a little crazy, determined, you know, I won't back down from a challenge, that's for sure. I'll do whatever it takes. I do, you know, just anything I need to as an athlete in the college level, you know, is every day working out, doing what I can, obviously fishing in between, but you know, it was, down to the, you know, tooth and nail fighting for it, whatever it takes, which is part of my competitiveness too. And you know, that's just who I am. How would my friends describe me? Like I said about myself, you know, probably a little crazy. I like to have fun. They probably say, you know, I'm outgoing, fun, charismatic individual. You know, I got a lot of friends. You know, I don't like to make enemies, but you know, the people like to hang out with me. You know, I just, if anybody's going out into the woods to hike, camp, fish, anything like that, I'm the guy they call. You know, they want to say, hey, what are you up to? Let's go for a hike. Let's go do something. They usually, it seems like they want me there, which is, I guess that's a good thing.
We live out in our old van, travel all across this land, me and you. And we'll end up hand in hand.
So why do I want to be on Top Hooker? Mainly the adventure. I mean, I'm looking for it. I've seen some of the other shows that Animal Planet has, you know, River Monsters, things like that, and that's just, that guy, Jeremy Wade, he's awesome. To be able to travel all over the world, catch these massive fish that just put up this huge battle, you know, these fish that look like they could take off an arm, that's just fantastic. I mean, that's just awesome. I'd love to be able to do that, and the main reason I want to be on it, you know, I'm competitive, I want to see more of the world, I want to go around, see places, do things. You know, I'm only 25. I haven't gotten a chance to travel around and do some fishing. You know, I haven't gone to Canada or Alaska yet. Haven't even got to go deep sea fishing or anything like that yet. It's mainly just fish in, you know, my neck of the woods, the Northeast, in the Adirondacks, you know, which I'm not saying it's not a bad place. I love it here. But, you know, I want to experience more things, get out and meet people, do things, do exciting things.
One of the great
fishing
stories I have is actually just this spring.
I was, you know, it was early season, I was fly fishing, water was high, water was cold, but we had a mild winter, so I heard that, you know, the trout and salmon fishing was good. So I went down to a river I usually go to. I go there probably, you know, three or four times a week if I can, and went down to the water, you know, was watching a couple guys on the other side of the river catching a few small rainbows, you know, 6-7 inches, you know, pulling them out here and there. And I rigged up my fly rod, I walked down to the river, walked down to the middle of the river, and I go to my buddy, I said, watch this, I'm gonna make this guy look like a fool. One cast, across the river, right at the bottom of my swing on my fly, boom. Salmon, landlocked salmon, about this big, you know, 23, 24 inch, about 5 pounds, nailed it. And you know, it was fantastic. The guys on the other side of the river were just blown away. They just sat down and watched, they didn't know what was going on. They had no idea a fish that big was in the river. Took me about 20 minutes to reel this thing in on a 5x, 5 weight, 5x tippet. And you know, I glance back over my shoulder. I see these like three guys standing on the bank watching me do this. And down the road, maybe, you know, quarter mile is this, this shop, you know, a fly fishing shop, fishing goods, bait goods, just in the middle of the Adirondacks, a little tiny mom and pop store type thing. But they're big into hunting and fishing. And next thing I know, you know, 10 minutes goes by, I look over my shoulder again, those three guys turn into 10, 12 people standing there watching me trying to catch this fish. So it was exciting, and I had everybody watching me. It was a great time, and you know, I'm getting the fish in close, and I realized, you know what? Crap, this fish isn't gonna fit in my net. So I had to pull a little river runs through it and, you know, kinda wade down in the water, float down a little bit and get in the shore and drag them in, but I got them, and it was a great fish, and the best part about it was, you know, I snapped a couple good shots with them. Revive them, let them go. You know, I'm really big into the conservation and nature. I really want to keep the fish around, and I want to bring awareness to that. You know, I'm a big proponent of that. Being a high school biology teacher, you know, I really want to focus on, you know, conservation, the environment, things like that, and really keep it around for the future. I mean, I love it so much, I don't want to see it go. So hopefully there'll be more big fish like that in the future, and you know, we'll see what has to come. Well, that's about all I have to say for you right now. Hopefully I hear from you guys. Hopefully I'm exciting enough for you. I mean, I can tell you right now, competitiveness, I'm up there. If there's a physical challenge, I'll tell you right now, I'm going to win it. Whether or not I win the whole thing, that's not what it's about to me. It's about the adventure and the excitement. You know, I'd be ecstatic just to be on the show and, you know, meet new people and try new things. But for now, I'm up here in the Adirondacks, and I'm going to do a little bit of fishing, so hopefully I hear from you guys. I'll see you later.